ओके स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 11th मैथमेटिक्स सीबीएसई। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉन्जुगेट एंड मॉडुलस ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर। ओके, बोथ द टर्म कॉन्जुगेट एज वेल एज द मॉडुलस ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स आर वेरी यूजफुल एज वेल एज द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स आर कंसर्न्ड एंड आल्सो इन अदर टॉपिक्स इन अपकमिंग चैप्टर्स। दिस टॉपिक इज इंपॉर्टेंट। ओके, so we will learn what does mean by the conjugate of a complex number. First of all, starting the conjugate number, the definition and the meaning and the representation of the complex conjugate of a complex number. Let z is equals to, z belongs to the set of complex number. The C is called as the set of complex numbers, means the set of all complex numbers. Okay, you know every real number can be represented as complex number. Okay, so C also contain the set of a real number, or what we can say, C is the biggest set of the numbers. It contains real numbers, it contains imaginary numbers, means it contains complex numbers. Okay, so let z belongs to C is any number of the form a plus iota b. A plus iota b, where a b belongs to the set of real numbers. Okay, now what is the conjugate of a complex number? Conjugate of a complex number is denoted as z bar. Conjugate of a complex number is denoted as z bar, and this is equals to a minus iota b. This is equals to a minus iota b. So what is the difference between complex number and conjugate complex number? It is a plus iota b, it is a minus iota b. Okay, so conjugate of a complex number is obtained after replacing iota by minus iota in the given complex number. Okay, how to obtain the conjugate of a complex number? Conjugate of a complex number is obtained after replacing iota by minus iota in the given complex number. Conjugate of a complex number is obtained after replacing iota by minus iota in the given complex number. Okay, so what is the conjugate of this z equal to? If z is equals to a minus iota b, then what is its conjugate? Then its conjugate is equals to z bar, and this is equals to a plus iota b. Okay, so replacing minus iota by iota or iota by minus iota, we obtained the conjugate of complex number. Okay, so conjugate of the complex number 3 plus 4 iota is z bar, that is 3 minus 4 iota, or conjugate of z equal to 3 minus 4 iota is z, that is 3 plus 4 iota. Okay, so conjugate of 3 plus 4 iota is 3 minus 4 iota, and 3 minus 4 iota is 3 plus 4 iota. Okay, so what we can say that conjugate of z is z bar, conjugate of z is z bar, and conjugate of z bar is z. Okay, both are conjugate of each other. Z and z bar, both are conjugate of each other. That is why 3 plus 4 iota is conjugate of 3 minus 4 iota, and 3 minus 4 iota conjugate of complex number 3 minus 4 iota is 3 plus 4 iota. Okay, so both the complex numbers are conjugate of each other. Okay, so this is the meaning of the conjugate of a complex number. Now we will discuss some of the important properties of the conjugate of a complex number. So let us write the property of conjugate of a complex number. नंबर. प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. ओके प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. द फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी इज द कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ ए कॉन्जुगेट कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इज द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इटसेल्फ फॉर ऑल जेड बिलोंग्स टू सी. मींस कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ ए कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इज द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इटसेल्फ. ओके मींस इफ वी टेक टू टाइम्स कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ द कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर देन वी ऑब्टेन द सेम कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. मींस कॉन्जुगेट विल कैंसिल द इफेक्ट ऑफ कॉन्जुगेट. ओके सो जेड बार ऑफ जेड बार इज इक्वल्स टू जेड. ओके दिस इज द फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर. दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी प्रूव हैव ए प्रूफ ऑल्सो. ओके सो सेकेंड वन इज जेड प्लस जेड बार मीन्स द एडिशन ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर एंड इट्स कॉन्जुगेट इज इक्वल्स टू ए प्लस आइटा बी प्लस ए माइनस आइटा बी एंड दिस इज इक्वल्स टू टू ए इक्वल्स टू 2 into A. And what is A? A is the real part of the complex number that is Z. So this is equal to 2 real part of Z. And third property, Z minus Z bar. This is equal to A plus iota B minus A minus iota B. A plus iota B minus A minus iota B. And this is equals to 2 iota B. So iota 2 imaginary part of Z. Okay. So Z minus Z bar is equals to iota 2 imaginary part of Z. Or simply the 2 imaginary part of Z. Okay, so this is the second property of complex number. Okay, now third. This is third property and fourth property is Z bar is equals to Z. If Z bar is equals to Z means if conjugate of a complex number is equals to the complex number itself, conjugate of a complex number is equal to the complex number itself, then A plus iota B is equals to A minus iota B, implies that 2 iota B is equals to 0, that is imaginary part is equals to 0, and imaginary part equals to 0 means Z having the imaginary part equals to 0 means the complex number having only the real part. So complex number is purely real. Complex number Z is purely real. Okay. So complex number Z is purely real if Z bar is equals to Z. If conjugate of a complex number is equal to the complex number, then the complex number is purely real. But fifth property is if z bar is equals to minus z, then a plus iota b is equals to minus a minus iota b is equals to a equals to minus a means 2a equals to 0. Means real part is equals to 0. Implies that real part of Z is equals to 0. Well, real part is equals to 0. It means complex number having only the imaginary part. That is why complex number is purely imaginary. Implies that complex number purely imaginary. Okay, so these are important conditions, these are important properties of the conjugate of a complex numbers. First one, double conjugate is the complex number itself. Z plus Z bar equal to 2 real part and Z minus Z bar equals to iota 2 imaginary part. Then Z minus Z bar is equals to this. And if conjugate of complex number equals to the complex number, then it is purely real. If conjugate of complex number equals to minus complex number, then it is purely imaginary number. Okay. Now let us discuss the another property. Other property, property number 6 of the conjugate complex numbers. Property number 6 of the conjugate complex numbers. That is, property number 6 is Z into Z bar. That is A plus iota B multiplied by A minus iota B is equals to, after multiplying these two, we have already have the multiplication of these two. So this is equals to A square plus B square. That is real part of Z square plus imaginary part of Z square. Okay. So Z bar equals to A square plus B square means real part of Z square plus imaginary part of Z square. Okay. So this one is also an important property. When we multiply complex number with its conjugate, we are having A square plus B square means real part of Z square plus imaginary part of Z square. Now the next property, property number 7, that is Z multiply Z, Z1, Z2, multiplication of Z1, Z2 whole bar is equals to Z1 bar, Z2 bar. Okay. Means the conjugate of multiplication of two complex number is the multiplication of the conjugate of the two complex numbers. Okay. And then 8th property is Z1 plus Z2 whole bar. Z1 plus Z2 whole bar, this is equals to Z1 bar plus Z2 bar. And then 9th property of the conjugate of complex number, that is Z1 minus Z2 whole bar, and this is equals to Z1 bar minus Z2 bar. And lastly, that is 10th property of the conjugate of complex numbers is Z1 upon Z2 whole bar is equals to Z1 upon Z2 bar. Means conjugate of division of two complex number is the division of conjugate of two complex numbers. Okay. So Z1 upon Z2 whole bar, whole conjugate is equals to Z1 conjugate upon Z2 conjugate. Okay. So all these are the properties of conjugate of a complex number. Conjugate of a complex number. Here we learn how to obtain a complex number. How to obtain a complex number by the given complex number. Okay. And then we have learned the different properties of the complex conjugate of complex numbers. Okay. Now we will start the next topic of today, that is modulus of complex number. Modulus of complex number and its properties. Okay. Modulus of complex number is also an important topic. Okay. So modulus of a complex number. modulus of a complex number. Let this is imaginary axis and this is real axis. This is real axis and at this is imaginary axis. Okay, real axis, x axis real axis and y axis imaginary axis. Let z equals to x plus alpha y is the complex number. Z equal to x plus alpha y is the complex number. We know that any complex number can be represented as the ordered pair of x and y. X is the real part and y is the imaginary part. So this can be write down as x y. This is organ plane having real axis and imaginary axis. Okay, this is organ plane having real axis and imaginary axis. Now we will plot this point on argand plane or complex plane. So this is the point P, x, y. Okay, and after drawing the perpendicular, this is x and this is y. Okay, since this is perpendicular, so using Pythagoras theorem, we are having OP equals to x square plus y square under root of OP equals to under root x square plus y square. OP is representing the given complex number. P point is the position of the point x, y, and OP is the complex number. OP is representing the complex number or the magnitude of the complex number or the length of the complex number. That is why OP is the magnitude. OP is the magnitude of complex number. OP is the magnitude of complex numbers. Okay, so magnitude of complex number is represented as magnitude z, modulus z. Modulus or magnitude, both are same. So magnitude of complex number is modulus z, and this is equals to OP, and OP equals to under root x square plus y square. Okay, so magnitude of z is equals to under root x square plus y square. Okay, so magnitude of a complex number is defined as under root x square plus y square, or we know that x is the real part of z and y is the imaginary part of z. Okay, so real part of z whole square plus imaginary part of z whole square, this is the magnitude of complex number z. Okay, so using this formula we can obtain the magnitude or the modulus of a complex number. That is very important in the study of complex numbers. Okay, now we will discuss the different properties of modulus of complex numbers. Okay, so let us discuss the properties of modulus of complex numbers. Now the first property is modulus z. Properties of magnitude of complex numbers. Okay, so first property is magnitude z square equals to, we know that magnitude z equals to under root x square plus y square. That is why magnitude z square equals to under root x square plus y square whole square. That is equals to x square plus y square. That is equals to real part of z square plus imaginary part of z square. But in the properties of conjugate complex number, we have learned that this is also equals to z bar. This is also equals to z conjugate. So this is equals to z conjugate. Okay, so modulus z square equals to z conjugate. This is the first property. This is the first property. Now we will discuss the second property. Now the second property is this. Modulus z is equals to under root x square plus y square, and my modulus z bar that is a minus iota b, or x minus iota y is equals to under root x square plus minus y square is equals to under root x square plus y square. Okay, this and this both are same. Also, magnitude of minus z, that is minus x plus iota y, is equals to minus x plus iota minus y, is equals to under root minus x square plus minus y square, is equals to under root x square plus y square. Okay, so this result and this result, all are same. And this result is the modulus z, and this is modulus z conjugate, and this is modulus minus z. Okay, so we can conclude that magnitude of z equals to magnitude of complex of z equals to magnitude of the negative of the complex number. Okay, so this is the second property of the magnitude of complex numbers. Okay, the next property is third property, that is real part of z is greater than equals to minus modulus z and less than equals to plus modulus z. Okay, this is the third property. Okay, similarly, the imaginary part of z is greater than minus magnitude z and less than equals to magnitude of z. Okay, so this is fourth property. Okay, now we will discuss the next property, that is, now the next property of the modulus of complex number is, next property of the modulus of complex number is and this property is fifth property. If magnitude z is equals to 0, magnitude z equals to 0 means under root x square plus y square equals to 0, means x square plus y square equal to 0, and the sum of square of two numbers is equal to 0 if both the numbers are 0. That is why x equals to 0 and y is equals to 0. Both are equals to 0 means z is equals to x plus iota y is equals to 0 plus iota 0 equals to 0. So if magnitude z is equals to 0, then the complex number is 0. Okay, or what we can conclude that magnitude of a 0 complex number is the 0. Magnitude of a 0 complex number is 0. Okay, so this implies this and this implies this. Both the results are vice versa results. Okay, so this was the fifth property. Next property, actually the serial number of property is not so determined. Okay, but the fact that we are learning in the particular property is important. Okay, so remember the fact, not the serial number of the property. Okay, but the next property, that is sixth property in this respect is magnitude of z1 plus z2 square is equals to magnitude z1 plus z2 whole square is equals to magnitude z1 square plus magnitude z2 square plus 2 real part of z1 z2 conjugate 2 real part of two real part of Z1, Z2 conjugate. Okay. Now next one is the 6th, 7th property. Magnitude of Z1 minus Z2 whole square equals to magnitude Z1 square plus magnitude Z2 square minus 2 real part of Z1, Z2 conjugate. Okay, so these are two property and important property. We should have the proof of these properties also. Okay, so we will prove one of the property, that is property number 5. This property we will prove. Okay, so magnitude Z1 plus Z2 whole square. We know that magnitude Z square equals to Z bar. Okay, so this is Z1 plus Z2 and Z1 plus Z2 whole bar. Okay, now this is equals to Z1 plus Z2 multiplying Z1 bar plus Z2 bar. We know that conjugate of sum of two complex number is the sum of conjugate of complex number. So Z1 into Z1 conjugate plus Z1 into Z2 conjugate plus Z2 into Z1 conjugate plus Z2 into Z2 conjugate. Okay, now this Z1 into Z1 conjugate is modulus Z1 square plus Z2 into Z2 conjugate is Z2 conjugate square, Z2 modulus square plus Z1 into Z2 bar, Z2 bar plus Z2 into Z1 bar. Okay, now this is Z1 into Z2 conjugate plus Z2 into Z1 conjugate. Z1 into Z2 conjugate plus Z2 into Z1 conjugate equal to 2 real part of Z1 Z2 conjugate or Z2 Z1 conjugate. Okay, so this is equals to modulus Z1 square plus modulus Z2 square plus this is equals to 2 real part of Z1 Z2 conjugate. Okay, so this is equals to this. Similarly, this can also be proved. Similarly, the result number 7 can also be proved. Okay, now we will draw one more result using the result number 6 and result number 7. Okay, by adding the result number 6 and result number 7, we will draw the result number 8. Okay, so adding result number 6 and 7, this is result number 8. Adding 6th and 7th, we have adding this magnitude Z1 plus Z2 whole square plus magnitude Z1 minus Z2 whole square equals to magnitude Z1 square plus magnitude Z2 square plus 2 real part of Z1 Z2 plus magnitude Z1 square plus magnitude Z2 square minus 2 real part of Z1 Z2. Okay, so this is equals to magnitude Z1 square plus magnitude Z2 square, 2 times of magnitude Z1 square plus magnitude Z2 square. Okay, so this is result number 8. Okay, now we will have some more result 9th and 10th. Okay, so next result is result number 9. That is magnitude of Z1 upon Z2 is equals to the magnitude of Z1 upon magnitude of Z2. That is the magnitude of division of two complex number. Magnitude of the division of two complex number is the division of the magnitude of the complex numbers. Okay, and one more result is here, that is result number 10, and that is magnitude Z1 Z2 is equals to magnitude Z1 मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ टू कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स, मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द मल्टीप्लीकेशन ऑफ टू कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर इज द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ टू कॉम्प्लेक्स नंबर्स. ओके, सो दिस इज द प्रॉपर्टी नंबर 10. सो वी हैव लर्न द टुडे इन दिस एपिसोड ऑफ द वीडियो और इन दिस एपिसोड ऑफ द क्लास वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द कॉन्जुगेट एंड द कॉम्प्लेक्स conjugate and the modulus of a complex number. Okay, and both the topic conjugate of complex number as well as the modulus of complex numbers are very useful in the study of complex numbers as well as in the upcoming chapters. Okay, so